press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello students, how are you? I hope that all are doing good, is it? So today I am here with you with the same lesson where we have stopped in the last class, the 100 dresses part second. So till now you have come to know about the characters, the main characters like Vanda Petronsky, the Peggy, and also Marilyn. We call her Maddie, is it, in this lesson. So you are familiar with these characters. So what are the characters and what kind of a qualities they had here in this story? And how I described in the lesson that what kind of a person the Vanda was, and what kind of a girl that is Peggy was, and what kind of a girl that is Maddie was. I told you, okay, in the class, in the before classes, in earlier classes I have told you, okay? So in this lesson, at last we come to the conclusion, after knowing that, okay, I have told you that who one is right here? Is it Vanda? Is it Peggy? Is it Maddie? And who are the responsible of all dates which was done by Peggy? Okay? So let's see in this lesson what happened in the next upcoming story. Is it she has written the letter? The Vanda was written the letter to Peggy and Maddie. So because they have written the letter and they have written there how she was won the prize, the contest for making the dress design. And they feel sorry for that. But they have written with the lots of love. They show the feelings for her. And you know, in the other situation, you know about Maddie. How she feels bad about Vanda because she left the school, she left the place because these girls are teasing to her. In the very first, she is not liking that the Peggy was teasing to this girl. And she never says stop and never used to stop to this girl. This Peggy. But now she has determined herself, not even Vanda, if she has got teased, if she was teased to any other person in the class, if Peggy was got teased to the any other person in the class, she would say stop. She would defend. She would support to those people. And she had come to the conclusion that so no one get teased to this Peggy and also some of the girls. And at last, she used to sleep at the night. But before she used to sleep, she was having a speech. She was prepared a speech about Vanda, about the situation. So when she would come to the school and how the people were gathered, how the girls were gathered, and how these girls are asking the questions about 100 dresses. And in that, in her support, she would say, stop. So all the situation she was imagining, she was thinking about Vanda, and she take a support. Okay? So like that, she feels bad, and she feels so sorry about the Vanda. Okay? So this is the character of Maddie. So let's move on to the next paragraph, what it is here. Now, it was Christmas time and there was snow on the ground. So this, now there are so many days are passed, the weeks also passed, and now it's a Christmas Eve, okay? And there are no response from Vanda. She has not written answer. She has not written it back the letter, okay? Then, Christmas time and there was snow on the ground. So you know the Christmas Christmas is celebrated in the month of December. So in the foreign countries, it means the countries like the Europe, okay? So there it is a winter season and everywhere there is a snow. Christmas bells and a small tree decorated the classroom. So everywhere in the school, in the classroom, it was decorated with the Christmas tree and there are bells. On the last day of school, before the holidays, the teacher showed the class a letter she had received that morning. So now there are their vacations are near. The students' vacations are near. They are going for holiday, okay, because of the celebration of Christmas. So that is the last day when the Miss Meisel has received the letter on particular day, okay, and she is showing to the class that letter. She is showing to the class. Now you can guess it, whose letter that is? Whose letter? Is it Vanda's letter? Is it someone's letter? Yes, let's see whose letter it is. You remember Vanda Petrovsky, the gifted little artist who won the drawing contest? Okay, now the Miss Meisel means the teacher says to the class, did you remember? You remember that Vanda Petrovsky? So who is the gifted little girl, artist? She's not using girl. She was an artist, a little gifted artist. She was a Vanda Petrovsky. Who won the drawing contest? She was won the drawing contest. Well, she has written me and I am glad to know where she lives. She has written the letter to me. To me means Miss Meisel, a teacher of the class. Okay? She has written letter to me. She used to say to the class like this. And I am glad to know that. She is happy to know that she is living in such a good city. Because now I can send her medal. And she knows the address now. The Miss Meisel, she knows the address where Vanda was living. Because for that she can send the medal she was won in the drawing competition. I want to read her letter to you. So what the letter she has written to me, so I wanted to read to you, class. So for the whole class she wanted to know that what she has written in that letter. The class sat up with a sudden interest and listened intently. Okay? So everybody, they know that she was a good artist, she was a designer, and now she was left. So all the things, they have known it, the whole class have known it. So everybody are eagerly, they are ready to listen the words of Miss Meisel. So what she has written in the letter, okay? Dear Miss Meisel, so she is reading the letter here, so I am also reading like a letter, okay? Dear Miss Meisel, how are you? And room 13, please tell the girls they can keep those 100 dresses because in my new house I have 100 new ones all lined up in my closet. I would like that girl Peggy to have a drawing of the green dress with the red trimming and her friend Mary to have the blue one. For Christmas, I miss that school and my new teacher does not equalize with you. Merry Christmas to you and everybody. Yours truly, Vanda Petrovsky. So here she has written the letter like this to the Miss Meisel and to the whole class and even the Peggy and Mary also. Because these two girls were written the letter to Vanda Petrovsky and now she is answering to that letter, okay? Dear Miss Meisel, so how she has begun the letter? How are you? She is asking that. And room 13, how these people are, how the whole class are and how you are. Please tell the girls they can keep those 100 dresses because in my new house I have 100 new dresses all lined in my closet. So how many dresses she had designed, that is 100 dresses she had designed it, is it? And tell the girls to keep those 100 designs dresses. Because in my new house, in my new home, I have a new 100 dresses and all it is lined in a closet, in my new closet. How she is expression it is. I would like that girl Peggy to have a drawing of the green dress with the red trimming. So here she is telling here to the Peggy. I like that girl. So because of that, I am gifting to her that is the designing, one of the designing of the dress, which was drawn like green dress, which is in a green dress, the design which is in a green dress, and which is a red trimming. It looks like a Christmas tree, okay? And her friend, Peggy, Maddie, Peggy's friend, who is here? Maddie, to have the blue one. And that girl should keep a blue one dress designing. For Christmas, I miss that school on my new teachers does not equalize with you. So this Christmas, I miss you all, and I miss the school. And even my new teachers, teacher is not equalized to you. They are not like you, okay? Merry Christmas to you and everybody. She is wishing to each and everyone, to the whole class, and she is supposed to wishing to the Peggy and the Maddie. Okay, because of them, she has moved, and because of them, she has designed the dresses. Okay, so they are the special to Vanda, and even Peggy and Maddie, they also feel that she is a special girl. Okay, but they had not understand the worth of Vanda. But when she left the school and she left the place, now they are understood the worth, the value of Vanda. Okay, so this is the answer by the Vanda to the letter which was written by Peggy and Mary. So the thought, you can see here, there is a thinking, the thought of the question, like the Peggy used to always, she used to ask the question like, how many dresses? 100 dresses? All the response of that question, she used to say 100 dresses all lined up. That sentence had repeated in this letter. It means that the thought, the thinking, it was deep-rooted in the mind of Vanda Petrovsky. Is it? It was deep-rooted. It was in a deep one. It is never going to be, she will never forget this incident, she will never forget this, the thing, whatever it was happened in the class. Till her old age or till her death, she will remember it. Okay, so because through this line we come to know about when we tease to somebody. So some of the insensitive people, I'm just giving an example to you. It's a general information. So when some people get teased, some of the sensitive people they will be. So they will never tolerate this kind of teasings. So when they feel ashamed in front of the people, in front of the class. So it leads to the bad condition to the particular person. Okay, see here the sentence, it has again, she was repeated. Okay, like 100 dresses, I have a new one in my new house, and all it is lined up. Okay, so that transfers the human nature. Okay, and maybe she went to some of the panic thing. She get mad. But actually, the parents understood it and they were shifted to the other place. Because that condition, that situation is not good for a growing child. Okay? It should be the healthy environment in the school. It should be the healthy environment among the people who are studying in the class. Is it? If the negative thoughts are arising like this to the particular person, then it is not good to the person for growing, for development of the mind and intellectual mind and for a physique. Okay? So that person loses the confidence. If they are in that condition, they lose the confidence. They develop the inferiority. And that one leads to the negative things and never come up with the positive one and never come up with the talent they can't show to the world. Is it? Through that we can understand in this lesson, if we get teased or we tease to the other people, if any people are insensitive in among those people, yes, if it is a home, if it is a class, if the people are friends together, it is okay because we know each other, so they will never mind it. They will not mind about that. If the people like the Vanda, and maybe some of the insensitive people, sensitive kind of people, So what they do, they will go to the depression and they loses their confidence. So this thing is a bad for the school and bad for our class and bad for our society. Okay? So always we should stand, we should have to support to the people like this. Okay? So this is the words I wanted to tell here. Okay? Before I'm saying to the moving to the next paragraph. I hope that you all are understood my words and my sayings, whatever I said here. On the way home from school, Mary and Peggy held their drawings very carefully. So now they are also happy about the Wanda has given this kind of a gift to the these two. Okay? All the houses had ruts wholly in the windows. In the windows, outside the grocery store, hundreds of Christmas trees were stacked, and in the window, candy peppermint sticks and cornucopias of shiny transparent paper was strung. Okay, so here is the description of the Christmas decorate, the whole class and the whole houses, it was decorated with the Christmas Eve, decorated with the Christmas things. Like with the small bells, okay? And also they used here some of the drawings and some of the wreaths and holly in the windows, okay? So which is used to celebrate during the time of Christmas. That is the kind of decorative things. Outside grocery store, hundreds of Christmas trees were stacked. So on the road, means on the streets and on the in the shops. So on the road they are decorated with their Christmas trees, and in the window candy peppermint sticks. So in the windows, so everyone's windows it was hung with the candy peppermint sticks, cornucopias of shiny transparent paper was strung. It means that the cornucopias means a decorative container usually full of flowers and fruits. Okay, the container which is filled with the flowers and fruits. So that is used in the decoration of Christmas Eve. It was in a transparent and shiny. Okay, you can see that during the Christmas Eve, so everything it is shining. It is a vibrant color they are using. Okay. The air smelled like Christmas, and light shining everywhere reflected different colors on the snow. So everywhere there will be the shining, and it was smell like a Christmas Eve. Okay, so you know that it is a kind of celebration, it is a kind of festival. So the world looks in a different way. Okay, the people, the environment, it looks in a different way. So here the smell is like a Christmas. Okay, and the light shining. So everywhere it will be the shining. It is when a bright in color. And everywhere it was reflected in the different colors of light. Okay, and it was reflected on the snow. So you can imagine it. Okay, you can imagine that. So how, if it is a winter season, if it is on the, if the place situated in the regions like Switzerland, or the place like England, okay? So then Kashmir, Jammu and Kashmir, where the snows appear, okay? So where, how they feel? Okay, everywhere there is a white snow and it was decorated. So every light and everything, it was reflected on the snow, okay? So like it is. Then, boy, said Peggy, this shows she really likes us. So she's here Peggy says the words, okay? Yes, this shows that she's also likes us. It shows that what it shows means in the letter, in the particular letter, she is taking the names of Peggy and Mary, and she has gifting the dress designing which was Vanna made, okay? So because from that sentences, it shows that she is also like us, okay? Then it shows she got our letter, and this is her way of saying that everything's all right, and that's that, okay? So now Peggy was something like analytical mind, okay? So she analyzes here. So this is the response. It means we can understood now. So she had got the letter. Because she had got the letter, so she is giving the answer like this to everybody. It means that everything is right. So her life is in a happy way. So she is also happy there. Okay, and from the words of Miss Meissen, so we can understood that she is fine in that place and everything is going to be fine now. Okay, fine and right there. I hope so, said Maddie sadly. But here Maddie is not happy. She feels sorry. Still now also she feels sad after receiving the letter from Vanda, and she got one of the design dress. Okay, so she is sad and she said to Peggy, I hope so. She felt sad because she knew she would never see the little tight-lipped polished girl again. I couldn't ever really make things right between them. Why she is sad here? She thought that she could never see the girl like Vanda in her life. Okay, so here it is description of a Vanda Petronsky. So how she is describing here? Tight-lipped polished girl. So tightly she was holding her lips in tight manner, and she was belongs to the Polish girl. She would never see this girl again in her life. Couldn't ever really make things right between them. And again, I can't make it right. So again, I can't turn the life in a back. Again, I can't do anything. So she left now. She got to know about this. So she feels sorry. She feels sad. Not sorry. Sad here. She went home and she pinned her drawing over a torn place in the pink flowered wallpaper in the bedroom. Okay, so when the Maddie went to home, she was hanged this design dress so in one of the wall, and that wall which was torn place, so a little bit it was torn. Okay, torn means it was not in a it was break or something, it was like not in a proper manner. It was torn that, and it was decorated with the pink flower wallpaper in the bedroom. So everywhere in her bedroom, it was decorated with the pink flower, and that was torn there. So there she was hanged it, okay? The shabby room came alive from the brilliance of the colors. Shabby, I told you, the Maddie's family's condition is also poor. By hanging of that design, the dress design, and now she come to the alive. She gives something life to that room with the brilliant color, with the vibrant color she has used. The Vanda was used in that designing. Maddie sat down on her bed and looked at the drawing. So she sat down on the bed and she was looking at the design, at the drawing. She had stood by and said nothing, but Vanda had been nice to her anyway. Simply she was looking to the drawing and she was not say anything, and she was staring to that drawing, okay? And she said nothing, but Vanda had been nice to her now anyway. Now Vanda had been nice to these people. She was forgot all those things now, okay? Tears blurred her eyes. She gazed for a long time at the picture. Blurred means now her eyes filled up with the tears, with the emotions, okay? With the emotion. And she was gazing. Gazing means she was looking continuously with the gaze one. With the deep thinking, she was looking to the drawing for a long time. Then hastily she rubbed her eyes and studied it intently. So when she was gazing to the picture, so suddenly her eyes were filled with the tears, with the emotions. And what happened? She rubbed her eyes because her eyes were filled with tears. And again she was studying this intently. Again she was studying that picture. The colors in the dress were so vivid that she had scarcely noticed the face and head of the drawing. The color which she was used, the vanda was used for the drawing, for the picture. It was vivid color. It was colorful one. It was a vibrant color. So she was not noticed the head of the drawing, head of the dress. Okay. Means the face and head of the dress. She was not looked at. Only she was looking the dress. But it looked like her, Mary. It really looked like her own mouth. Why, it really looked like her own self. Vanda had really drawn this for her. Excitedly, she ran over to Peggy's. So when she was observing the face and head of the picture in that dress, so she find out that is a Mary. Okay, in that picture, the face which resembles to Mary. And again she was looked. In her own mouth, she was tell that she is a Mary. She called her names in her mouth. Why it is really looked like her own self? Why this picture it is looking like myself? She was thinking, it is my own self. Vanda had really drawn this for her. So Vanda, now she was thinking that, now she was understand that Vanda was drawn for Mary only. Okay, so that particular design which was drawn by the Vanda, it is for Mary, because the face was resembles to Mary. Now she was excited. She ran over to Peggy's. She feels very happy. Suddenly she ran to the Peggy's house. Peg, she said. Now she is screaming. She was exclaimed, let me see your picture. She was screaming like that. So can I see your picture? What's the matter? Asked the Peggy. So now she has responded, what's the matter? Why you are asking the picture? Who asked you? Peggy was asked. As they clattered means a loud disturbance. So there is disturbance in her voice. Up to her room where Vanda's drawing was lying face down on the bed. Okay. So now they all ran away to the Peggy's room. And that picture was lying on the bed. And the face was towards on the bed. Okay. Face down on the bed. Mary carefully raised it. So suddenly she was raised the picture. Okay. Look. She drew you. So Mary, she was exclaimed like that with a surprise. Look at this. She has drawn to you. She is you. That's you. She exclaimed. She was in a surprise and she was explained to the Peggy. She is you. And head of the face of this picture did look like Peggy. Yes, it is true. The picture, the head and face of the picture, it looks like a Peggy now. So, I have told you. So, in the letter, she said that, so the dresses which she was designed, so that designs, picture should give it to Peggy and Mary, according to her, okay, according to the Vanda. Why she said like that? Because that two particular pictures, she was drawn to the Peggy and Mary only. Okay, so now these two girls were understand now, because of the dresses, they never observed the face and head of the picture. They only looked the dresses. Okay, then because of that dresses, they have not observed the face of the picture. Now the Mary has observed it, that this particularly it has designed to me. And this one, the Peggy's picture is also designed particularly to the Peggy only. Okay? Then, so what happened in the next year? What did I say? Said Peggy. So what I want to say now? Said Peggy. What I could say now? She must have really liked us anyway. So after listen the words, after the, you know that the Miss Meissen's when she was read the letter, by hearing the words, like that design, the picture should give it to Mary and Peggy. So Peggy said that, yes, because from that letter, so she has responded, she has answered to our letter. It means that she was liked us, okay? She is liking to us. Now, after knowing that, these designs were particularly made for these two girls. So now they have understood that, yes, she was really liked us. But they have never understand the feelings of Wanda, understand the emotions of Wanda. But now she was went away, she was gone from that place. Now they are understanding that. So this girl is really liked us. But now, so they are helpless, they can't do anything now. Okay? Yes, she must have agreed Maddie. Yes, yes, you are right. She is lacking to us, said Maddie. She is also agreed the words of Peggy. And she blinked away the tears that came every time. So Maddie, so whose eyes were filled with tears? The Mary's eyes. Because even there are so many days were passed and she could not forget the Wanda. She isn't sad when she was missing to Wanda. Although she would never talk, they would never talk each other. Maddie is also not made a friend with Wanda. But after she left this place, now she is missing that girl. Thought of Wanda standing alone in that sunny spot in the schoolyard. So suddenly her eyes were filled with tears. She was blinking her eyes. And she is thinking about Wanda. So what is the situation? She is thinking the situation like the girl was standing alone. So in her picture, when she closed her eyes, there is a picture come in her eyes and she was thinking about Wanda, that Wanda was standing alone in the schoolyard, that is in a sunny spot. It is the bright day. So in that day, so she was standing alone in the schoolyard, looking stolidly over at the group of laughing girls after she had walked off. So stolidly means not showing any feeling. So imagine the picture, means when she was guess the picture of Wanda, when she was in the schoolyard in the bright sunny way and there are no girls with her, she's standing alone there and here, and she is not having any feeling at that particular time. Okay, so that is Wanda's situation. She is assuming here now. So every girl now she is thinking that all the girls which they were made the group, okay, and there the Wanda was standing alone, and girls after she had walked off. And when she was walked from that place, after she had said, sure, 100 of them all lined up. After she was walked off from that place, yes, sure, 100 of that was lined up. That dialogue, that sentence, she was remembered. Who has remembered here? Maddie was remembered. So always the Maddie was missing to this girl, Wanda Petronsky. Okay, so this is about the story, so which is very beautiful story, and here there are three characters, and here is the minor character called Miss Meissen. Okay, so they can connect to the Wanda Petronsky. So these are the things we can come to know about this lesson from part first and part second. Okay, so I hope that you are not getting confused about part first and part second. So it is clear that in the part first, the story, it was not completed, it was in the half end, and the next half of the story, it is continuation in the part second. Okay, so now the Maddie, so she is always missing that girl, she never forget this girl, even Wanda also, okay? Because of these people, she left the school and she was drawn the pictures, okay? and she has won the contest. And she is also never forget those things, those incidents which was happened in the class and in the school. You can say Peggy was a not sensitive girl. She's not a sensitive girl, but Mary was a sensitive girl here in this story. She's not mind about anyone. She was a careless. Actually, she's not a careless, but she don't express herself. Peggy, she's not expressing herself. Okay, the way she used to think for the Wanda, she's never expressed herself. Mary always she's expressing. She also feels sorry. She also feels sad about Wanda. She was left the school and left the place, but she has never expressed herself. But Mary was expressed herself again and again. Okay, so this is the story. Okay, so today I have completed this lesson. I hope that you all are enjoyed and you all are enjoyed the character, you have drawn the image in your mind. So how it was, how it should be, how the characters these are, is it? So I hope that you all are enjoyed this one. Before I am going to finish this class, so there are some activity has given here in your textbook, so it's important to you to understand the qualities of the human being. Okay, so you can say the negative qualities and positive qualities. You know, we all are human beings. We have some negative characters and positive characters and the qualities also. So let's see how much you are known about, how much you are familiar with those qualities. Okay, so let's see here. The page number 80, thinking about a language. Here there are 30 adjectives describing human qualities. Discuss them with your partner. Okay, there are 30 adjectives. Adjectives means it says the quality, it modifies the qualities of a noun or a pronoun. Okay, so here describing the human qualities, discuss them with your partner. So you should have to discuss this with your partner, means with your friends or with your brothers and sisters. Okay, then it better to discuss with your friends who are in your class. Put them in the two words webs. Okay, so you have to draw the two webs which is present in the textbook here. There are two webs are given in the textbook. According to whether you think they show positive or negative qualities, you can consult a dictionary. If you are not sure of the meanings of the some of the words, you may also add to the list the positive or negative pair of the given word. Okay, according to the this sentence means this heading. So what it is saying here there are some negatives and positive qualities are given here. There are some 30 adjectives given. So which 30 adjectives which says the negative qualities and positive qualities of the human being, and which are the qualities you are familiar with. So you have to draw the web, the two webs like positive and negative, and write the adjective in particular. Positive one web and negative one web. Okay, so then if you don't know the meaning of the qualities, like the qualities are given here, so you can use the dictionary for the meanings, to find out the meanings. Okay, so from understanding of the meanings, you should write the particular word related to either it is for positive or negative. Okay, negative thing, negative qualities of human being. So let's see which are the words given here in the textbook. Kind, sarcastic, courageous, or you can say courteous, arrogant, inspired, timid, placid, cruel, haughty, proud, zealous, intrepid, sensitive, compassionate, introverted, stolid, cheerful, contented, thoughtless, vain, friendly, unforgiving, fashionable, generous, talented, lonely, determined, creative, miserable, complacent. So these are the adjectives which describes the negative qualities and positive qualities of human being. So you should have to write the particular one adjective to the one web. Okay, if you know, if if the sum of the word which is matched to those two means, you can write there and here. Okay, so then this is the, and next sentence I am moving to the, that what adjectives can we use to describe Peggy, Wanda and Mary. You can choose the adjectives from the least above. You can also add some of the, some of your own. So here in this second main, so what has given here, the three characters name has given here, like Peggy, first is Wanda, Peggy and Mary. Okay, so there are some adjectives out there. So which particular word means which particular adjective is suited for particular person, you should write it. You should have to describe there to the particular person, particular character in the lesson. Okay, so then, and if you know more, if you have your own adjectives to the particular characters, you can write. Okay, so here they have written. So one example I wanted to give here, that is Peggy. Okay, so Peggy, so you can say talented. The girl, she is talented. She is more talented in the class. And now, and you can say the next to Wanda. So Wanda, she was a creative. She was a creative and sensitive. Sensitive girl. Okay? The quality she has, that is sensitive and creative. Then Mary. So what kind of a word you can use, what kind of a quality you can give to Mary here? She is like miserable. Okay? She is miserable. She is sad. She feels sad about Wanda. Okay? And friendly. Then you can say talented, she is also talented, okay, and she is also feel proud. So you can use any qualities according to the lesson. So when you know about the characters of these, when you know the qualities of these characters, so you can have to draw the qualities, you can write the qualities and you can draw the picture if you want. Pictures means the quality pictures. So here the positive and negative is there, no? So there you have to write the words which is called as adjectives. Okay, so this is about the two activities I wanted to give you because it is helpful for you to judge this lesson. Okay, and you can judge the characters here, because these two stories like part one and part second, it is based on the judgment. Okay, so it is right or wrong, and who is right here and who is wrong here. I have, in the beginning I told you, nobody is wrong here, but the environment they have brought it, that is the wrong one. Okay, so this is the thing, this is this lesson. I hope that you all are enjoyed, you all are understood this lesson. Okay, all of you, stay safe, stay connected and keep learning. Thank you all.